In the last video, we looked at how AC circuit behaves when we have a pure resistance. In this video, let us explore another circuit with only pure inductance. Although every device has some resistance, we assume that this is a circuit with only inductance. It has a thick coil wound on an iron core. The circuit does not have capacitance and resistance components. So, as in the case of resistor, when you supply an AC current to this circuit, the AC current passes through the inductor coils. Inductors have a special property. They'll not allow the current passing through them to change immediately. Because when there is a change in current flowing through them, they produce a changing magnetic field. Due to this changing magnetic field, there'll be an EMF or voltage in the coil. This phenomenon is known as self-inductance, and the EMF produced is called as back EMF. This is according to the Faraday's law of electromagnetic induction. The EMF produced or induced opposes the cause producing it according to the Lenz law. So, the EMF will oppose the changing AC current. As there is no resistance, there will be no voltage drop across the inductor. The supply voltage has to overcome this back EMF to flow in this circuit. If the device has an inductor, it will not start off and shut down immediately. Let us look at the expression for voltage and current. We consider the supply voltage to be V equals Vm sin omega t and the self-induced EMF in the coil as EL is equal to minus L into di by dt. L is the coefficient of self-inductance given in Henry. In this circuit, the supply voltage is equal and opposite to the self-induced EMF at every instant. So, Vm sin omega t is equal to minus of minus L into di by dt. Negative sign indicates that they are opposite in nature. We will solve this equation for current. So, di will be equal to Vm sin omega t into L into dt. We have just rearranged the terms. So, if we integrate both the sides, we will get the instantaneous current value. So, integral of di is equal to integral of Vm divided by omega L into sin omega t into dt. On simplification, I is equal to Vm by omega L into minus cos omega t. As integral of di is I and integral of sin omega t is minus cos omega t, Vm by omega L stays out of integration as they are constants. We have the instantaneous value of current as I is equal to Vm divided by omega L into cos omega t. We have general rule of representing voltage and current in sine functions. So, in this equation, we convert cos into sine. That will be I is equal to Vm divided by omega L sine of omega t minus pi by 2. So finally, I is also equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. Let's compare the expressions of voltage and current of pure inductance circuit, that is V is equal to Vm sin omega t and I is equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. This clearly tells us that there is a phase difference between the current and voltage. Current is lagging by 90 degree or pi by 2 radians from voltage. This means current reaches the maximum value after the voltage has reached its maximum. The difference is 90 degrees. So, the voltage is leading the current in reaching the max value. Now, let us look at the phasor diagram. As current lags the voltage by 90 degrees, the phasor has to be 90 degrees apart. current is taken as reference in all the circuits and it is written as a straight line. Voltage is written 90 degrees away and ahead the current line in the upward direction, suggesting that it is leading the current. Now, the last thing we need to learn is about power. Power is equal to V into I. Substituting the V and I values, P is equal to Vm sin omega t into Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. So it is P is equal to Vm Im sin omega t cos omega t. Again, the trigonometric formula comes in very handy. We have the formula sin 2 omega t as 2 sin omega t cos omega t. So sin omega t cos omega t is equal to sin 2 omega t divided by 2. Therefore, power is equal to Vm Im divided by 2 into sin 2 omega t. If we integrate and calculate the power over one complete cycle, we'll get power value as 0 due to sin term in the power equation. So, in pure inductive circuits, the power absorbed is 0. Even the power curve suggests that the power over one complete cycle is 0. We can see the alternative positive and negative values of the power. Hence, we can conclude that the net power is 0. The final concept in this video is about reactance. In the expression Im is equal to Vm divided by omega L, L is known as reactance or it is denoted as XL. It plays the part of resistance in the inductive circuit. This is all about AC circuits with pure inductance. To sum up, in this video, we learned behavior of voltage and current, phasor diagrams. We also learned that the current lags voltage by 90 degrees. And then we came to know that the power absorbed will be zero in pure inductive circuit. In the next video, we look at AC circuits with pure capacitance.